But we're talking about the awards and the celebration today. And in the studios, I have Oye Asare. She produces vegetables in a greenhouse environment. She's been doing this for over 8 years. And also, I have Philip Abayori. He's the president of the Ghana Agricultural Chamber of Commerce. Good morning, and thank you so much for joining me.
Thank you.
A good day to celebrate farmers, right?
Yeah,
it is
very fantastic. We are very happy. It's a joyful day for us that we have been recognized for our tremendous contributions to feeding Ghanaians and to national development. So we are very happy that a day has been selected to award us and also to recognize the work that we do.
Okay, we've been celebrating farmers since, well, officially since 1985.
87
rather.
Yes, yes.
Okay, but it's been how many years, and we're still, our industry is fraught with a lot of challenges. Quite recently there have been talks about the ban of rice imports and all of that, because we produce so much and yet we don't have people consuming locally produced rice and other products as well. And so there are many challenges. So why are we still going ahead to celebrate if we've not been able to address some of these challenges? What are we celebrating?
Yeah, we are celebrating the achievement of the farmers. Though with all difficulties, the farmers have not laid down their tools. We have never laid down our tools. We always continue to be patriotic to our nation, and we continue with all the challenges to produce, to feed our population, and also to make a living.
Yeah,
I will say that agriculture has been transformed tremendously. If you cast your mind back, you realize that we had less opportunities. Today, previously, we were producing for mere subsistence, and we go in to produce to feed ourselves. Now, agriculture is geared towards agribusiness, and farmers are producing not for mere subsistence but for commercial gain. So that is a transformation, and the mindset that you produce to make an income and also to feed yourself. So that is where we are today. And if you look at the team of the farmers there now, it's enhancing smallholder agriculture towards agribusiness.
Okay.
So that is the vision.
All right.
Of agriculture today.
Let me bring Oye in, because earlier you were telling me that you don't believe in the celebration of Farmers Day.
Yes, because I believe when you are able to empower the farmer, put in right policies, give them the resources. One farmer in a year doesn't need a house. If you empower every farmer, I can afford. The farming business will be so lucrative. And we should also have the mindset of farming as a business. When it's lucrative and I'm making profit, I can fly myself to Mauritius, Sao Tome, whatever island I want to go and relax. I can afford to buy a house. I don't need the government to, out of a million farmers, to give one person a house.
It's not enough?
It's not enough for one person, two people. So what you have to do is put in general policies, empower the farmers, and let them produce at a profit. Let them see the farming as business, like any other business.
But that's what they've been focusing on. I mean, when we talk about this year's theme, it says enhancing small-scale towards agribusiness development. I remember that the information minister sometime in September also mentioned that we're shifting from peasant farming or subsistence farming to agribusiness. So that's been the focus for a while. And the government in power has said constantly that they have improved the conditions in the farming industry measurably. And so if you're saying that giving a pat on the back of one farmer a year is not enough, is that not asking for too much, especially with all the work that has gone into enhancing the agri sector?
I'm not saying it's not enough, but it's not enough in a sense. We have more than 40,000 over farmers.
Yeah.
What you want to do is to empower farmers. Make it lucrative. Let people come in. Let graduates who have just come out of universities come in and farm and make profit that they can afford. They can afford their houses.
Yeah.
They can afford everything. That makes it a business. That makes it lucrative for someone to come in. But if we have to wait for every year for one farmer out of the lot to be given a house, what happens to the living of other farmers? So I'm not saying the house is not good, but that is not it. Farming is a business.
What encouraged you to go into farming, first of all?
First of all, I felt I wanted to do something productive.
Okay.
Something that will add to the economy, not about just buying and selling something from another country.
So that's what you were doing before? You were a trader?
Yes. I used to buy stuff and sell.
And sell, okay.
And I felt, let me do something productive. And I also was into the, I was with an investment company as well.
Okay.
And so let me do something productive for my country. And apart from that, we realized that on air, you see a lot of places, go to places where you see people producing vegetables and the standards and everything cannot be traced and they are using filters. So I felt something better could be done. Mm. So let's get on board and do something that will benefit the whole nation.
What are some of the challenges that you faced, especially when you started, you know, the farming business?
Honestly, no bank or no institution is ready to help a startup.
Mm.
That's the most important, especially when you tell them you're a startup. No one is prepared to help you.
Is it only for the agric sector? Or
especially because they see the agric sector as very risky.
Okay.
If I go to any bank working and tell them I'm doing a supply business or I'm buying goods and selling, I'll easily get a facility.
Yeah.
But if you tell them you're going to use it for agric, and especially if you're a setup, they are asking for 2 to 3 years audited accounts.
Hmm.
And how would a young graduate come in with a 2-3 years audited account to get facility to be able to farm?
Mm-hmm.
So those are some of the challenges.
So you had to invest your own money into
it? Yeah.
So how long did it take you? Were you able to go back to the facility to at least get some funds, or you've been able to still grow your business without the support?
Yes, I had support. I had to talk to people to get involved and to also support. And I realized that sometimes the risky part, why I shifted from the open field to the greenhouses, the risky part is sometimes you grow your stuff and then maybe the rains, you are left to the mercy of the elements.
Yes.
But in the greenhouse, it's a controlled environment and you control whatever happens in there.
So it's better.
It's better.
Philip Abayori, let me ask you this, because you are the president of the Ghana Agricultural Chamber of Commerce. When it comes to the issue of funding for farmers in the country, that's of grave concern, especially because even in the documentaries that we watched, the reports that we watched, everybody literally said that I'm struggling with funds. Nobody's ready to invest in my business because they don't believe that I can make the returns. Quite recently, there was a report about how the banks fear, making their returns, especially when they invest in the agricultural sector. What has the Commerce been able to do to support some of these people and to encourage some of these banks to support these farmers?
You see, if you look at the average loan portfolio in the country, agriculture takes only 4%, which is very, very meager. And some of the reasons given by the banks are uncalled for, because in every sector there is risk. Today we have agricultural insurance.
Yeah.
So if a farmer comes and wants to pick a loan, you could ask that farmer to go pick an insurance. And that could mitigate the risk that at least will come. In other words, we also look at irrigation. In some areas, some of the crops, there's irrigation, and we keep on encouraging government for public good to expand the irrigation facilities in the country. Because when you are growing crops and then you have irrigation, because the issue is climate change has come to stay. The rains are erratic. We cannot more predict the weather accurately. So you may grow your crops, and then the issue of rains or floods, and there are issues. So, but then, because we have an agricultural insurance pool, that risk is being minimized.
Okay.
So I think that it is a concerted effort that has to be made by the banks to invest in agriculture. You all realize that we have concentrated in mopping up money, reinvestment, and et cetera, and et cetera. And if you look at the amount of money that people have even lost for trying to make more money.
Yeah.
To have secondary income. Every Ghanaian wants to have secondary income. Wherever he is, he wants to have more, and et cetera. Yeah. But I think agriculture, investing in the agricultural sector is one of the best. But you see, people do not want to invest directly in primary production. They want to invest into something that at least there should be a quick turnover. So post-harvest management is one of the issues.
Yeah.
And then also of taking agricultural produce from the local producers, repackaging it, and then promoting and marketing it. So this is the challenge that we currently face. But in terms of agricultural financing, it's really an issue.
Mm-hmm.
And we are hoping that there's currently, you know, in the budget, there have been some initiatives that government has come out for.
Yeah, yeah.
Even going to get even the current 4%, you go in and you want to borrow, you have, an agricultural enterprise, or even you are doing your mare farming. You have some particular agricultural activity which has a gestation period of 3, 4, 5 years.
Mm-hmm.
And so if you go and you are borrowing and they give you 1 year, they give you 6 months, you are going to have a challenge. So we need to be able to have, medium to long-term financing. That will allow farmers to be able to employ technology and also to expand.
Yeah.
So these are all the challenges that are within the financing of agricultural sector, and we're looking up to be able to, overcome this hurdle.
But whose job is it to make it attractive? Is it the farmers? Is it government? Especially, you know, when you want funding from these banking sectors, and also for young people, because you tell them, I think you should go into agriculture, and they're looking at you like, what did you just say? I didn't go to school to become a farmer. You know,
if you understand agriculture, you can go in to be purchasing produce, packaging them, and then it's part of agriculture.
Mm-hmm.
It's a chain. You can go provide technology to the farmer or supply inputs to the farmer. It's a whole industry.
Mm.
You can go in and, provide relevant services. So you don't necessarily need to go for primary production.
Yeah.
And, if we look at agricultural production in general, you need various expertise, because we want to move agriculture from mere subsistence to commercial viable enterprises.
Mm-hmm.
So our youth who are well educated, we need them in there. The only thing is, how do they place themselves?
Exactly.
So we should demystify the difficulties and try to rather look at a way to be able to get them into the agriculture.
How do we get them in? That would be my last question to you.
We can. That's what I've just said.
Yeah,
You can go to market Malata Market. You see our women who are doing tremendously very well and distributing the food across the country.
Mm.
It will marvel you when you drive in the night and you realize that they are sitting behind these trucks. They are picking food from region to region in trucks, and they are able to distribute this. You go, they put them on tables. But the issue is that they are not able to package.
Yeah.
If you take this and then you pick up a product, you look at it, you go to, standard board, you check about, purities, and some particular, make it a product.
Mm.
And you could name it into your name, Abnaya,
so
Pepe,
many ways
and put it there. Because
okay.
You see, we have a middle class. And they want to eat what at least is appropriate.
Yes.
And to go down to the local marketplace sometimes is even a challenge. And that is why sometimes they will patronize the imported product, because they believe that is well labeled, mm-hmm. and etc.
Mm-hmm.
But we have the products here. We only perhaps do not have the people who have the knowledge base of the farmer. It's not even the duty of the farmer to have even come to the marketplace.
Okay.
But we have a system that needs to be
All right.
handled properly.
If you ask me, I think that we should celebrate Farmers' Day. It shouldn't be Farmers' Day, it should be Farmers' Month. If we can do Made in Ghana Month in the month of what, March?
Yeah.
Why can't we have a celebration for agriculture in general for a whole month, where there are a series of activities to educate farmers, to encourage more people to invest? We can have a Farmers' Week where there's produce, you'd be encouraged to grow your own crops at home and all of that. Maybe that's where you'd even appreciate the celebration a bit better.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Yeah.
So you agree with the fact that it should be more than just a day celebration?
I believe so.
Yeah.
I think a lot should go into it. And one thing I was talking about, the government is trying to get maybe investors to come in.
Yeah.
But one thing we do is, when there's a glut for a month or two,
mm-hmm.
we cry and we are looking for people to come and invest, to produce it, to set up factory. But the truth is, if you have a glut for 2 months and an investor comes in, after the 2 month glut, how does he get the raw material?
Mm-hmm.
So we should look at a holistic approach to develop the raw material system, so that when anybody comes to invest, it will be worth it.
All right, definitely. Thank you so much for joining me. I've been speaking to Oye Asare. She's a vegetable farmer. She produces vegetables in a greenhouse environment. Been doing this for over 8 years. And Philip Abayori is the president of the Ghana Agricultural Chamber of Commerce. They head over to 3FM as well. And so if you want to hear more from them, you know what to do. But